want our history to guide us. Like I said, we are building a democracy and we are building a country. I just want our history to guide us as we continue to comment on some of these things. But like I said, I will not stand on the way of Parliament if Parliament decides that they want to investigate this matter and help us make sure that we reform the military that we have. And I agree perfectly that if there is a way to ensure that the military is not the first point of call when there's an issue in terms of civilian control, I'll be very, very excited. I'll be very excited that the military should not be the first point of call when there is an issue when we are dealing with the civilians. We should be able to help the police be able to do that and do that effectively. Mr. Speaker, I thank you very much. When the report comes and when our findings are also ready, we'll make it public to the people and make all the measures that we are going to take public to the people of Ghana for them to know what has happened. Our aim is to ensure that that never gets repeated again. You cannot say that things like this will never happen, because even the teeth and the tongue, you may one day have that kind of problem, but we are insisting that we don't want that thing to ever happen again as much as possible. So whatever we all do as a body in Parliament and as a country to ensure that we reform it, not to get these things to happen, I'll be very much interested in that. And I want to support my colleagues to be able to do that.